program. So if you're just learning about it now, refer back to prior weeks so that you can get with the program and start at any time. If you've been with me for the past 5 weeks, congratulations, you're almost there. This week's workout consists of leg support, arm support, and a blast and burn workout, which contains strength and cardio movements. During weeks 2 and 4, you did a leg support and arm support. So you'll pick your favorite workout during those 2 weeks and do it this week. Now the blast and burn workout consists of all the exercises that you've learned in the past. So I will mix them up for you and show you what to do during your 6 week workout. The setup for week 6 blast and burn workout begins on a high level incline, squat stand attached. You'll come down to your glide board, placing your feet on the squat stand for plie squats. Knees follow your toes on the plie. Try to get deep, full range of motion each time. Next, you go into a cardio movement of plie jumps. Bend the knees immediately upon landing to absorb the fall. Next, you go into air jumps. Split the legs in the air and land light through the knees when you land. Next, you position your feet for squat and squat pulses. Again, full deep range of motion through your legs. You can add variety by changing the position of your feet. And as your final range of motion, hold it down and pulse at your lowest range. And you can add the variety again through your feet to change the angle of the muscle worked. Extend through the legs for single leg jumps. So you can alternate these jumps, or for more intensity and leg work, you can stay on one leg, and of course, change legs. Next, we'll go to pendulum swings. So you'll hop from side to side, as the leg extends, bend through the leg, and absorb your landing. Next, you'll go into bridge and press out. Heels to the very top. Lift up through your hips, bending the knees and extending out. Lengthening through the leg as well as squeezing through the glutes and hamstrings. More intensity, single the leg. Keeping your hips square each time. Next, you'll bring this glide board all the way down, position your hands at the top for leg lowers. So the legs will lift up and down. You can add variety by taking them out to the side. And for more advanced, lift up through your hips. Roll your body down and remove yourself for glute presses. One foot on the squat stand, one onto the glide board, and you'll press, lengthening through the back of your leg and really squeezing your hamstring and glutes. Be sure to do this exercise on both sides. Now we'll remove the squat stand, place it out and off to the side. Go ahead and connect your pulley to your glide board, and then take your incline to a medium level. You'll go into a cardio movement of knee repeaters. One foot is on the glide board and repeat the knee. For more core activation, add a rotation over the knee. Be sure to do this exercise on both sides. Next, we'll go into sumo skips. More intensity, lift up through the arms. For more advanced, get low and high. Next, we'll go ahead and grab the handle, anchor down to a kneeling position for bicep, tricep, shoulder circles. So we do one bicep, one tricep, and circle it around. One bicep, one tricep, and circle. For a little advance, come up to a high kneeling, scoop the abs in, and then circle it around. Again, bicep, scoop the abs, and circle. Anchor down, you'll release one handle. You come either to a seated or kneeling position for diagonal cable chops. You'll go from one hip to the shoulder. For more core activation and range of motion, come to a high kneeling position. Be sure to do this exercise on both sides. Next, you'll come to a prone back extension flat row. Grab high on the cable, anchor down, and come to the prone position. Go lift up through your torso while you pull the cables down. You lift up and lower, really activating through your upper back as well as your lower. For more intensity, lift your lower body as well. So you lift up upper body as well as lower body to get full range of motion and activation in your spine. Anchor down, remove yourself, and you'll disconnect the pulley, placing it into the pulley pocket. Take your incline down to a low level. And you'll do one push-up, one knee in. So you have three levels here. You'll do beginner on your knees, one knee in, and intermediate, glide board is closed, one push-up, one knee. And for you advanced ones out there, open the glide board, one push-up, one knee. And then we go into our final cardio exercise of mountain climbers on the glide board. So either keep it closed and do the exercise, or open up the glide board and do your mountain climbers. It adds more shoulder stabilization as well as core work for the movement. And there you have it, your total blast and burn workout, and you're ready to repeat the entire circuit 1 to 3 more times. Good luck. Give me some feedback. I'd love to hear from you, and I'd love to hear the results that you've achieved over the past few weeks.